demi gods like Indra, Chandra, according to Vedic literature, there are different demigods. Sometimes you will find in Greek mythology the gods of the water, gods of the thunderbolt. These are not imagination, actually they are facts. But due to our insufficient knowledge, we do not know how the material nature is being controlled. When Krishna was on this planet and he was playing the part of a cowherd boy, and it was known to all over the universe that God has come, taken incarnation, and he is on the earth planet, and he is at Vrindavan playing the part of a cowherd boy. So as if somebody, if there is incarnation of God, somebody believes and somebody does not believe. When Krishna was actually present on this earth, it is not that everybody understood that Krishna was the Supreme Personality of God, not even up to that. Only few persons, the five brothers of the Pandavas and the damsels of Vrindavan, only in the fingers count, say, out of the whole population, say 100 or 200 men knew him, that he was the Supreme Personality of God. Otherwise, everyone thought that he is an ordinary man, just like one of us, but the most powerful, that's all. Similarly, they are demigods in other planets, they also thought, he is a foolish person, they are thinking of a cowherd boy as God, sophisticated, like that. Especially Indra, the heavenly kingdom, king of heaven, he's very powerful, so he thought, what God he has come, my God he cannot come. This was some speculation, even Brahma also speculated. But Krishna wanted to show Indra that yes, actually I have come. But that incident is today Govardhan Puja. So, Bhagavan api tatraiva baladevara sangjitaha apashyan nivasan gopan indriya jaga kritodvama. Indriya jaga kritodvama. According to Vedic system, there are different types of sacrifices to offer respect and obediences to the demigods. Just like the sun is supplying light, the moon is supplying moon sign. Similarly, Indra is supplying the cloud. Similarly, there are different demigods. And in the Bhagavad Gita, Devan, Jajayanti, Devu Bhavan, these things are described. In the Vedic literature, it is prescribed that you should satisfy these demigods by sacrifice. Devu Jaja. So, in the village of that Vrindavan, the father of Krishna, foster father of Krishna, Nanda Maharaj, and his associates, they were yearly perform in the Indraja. Because they were agriculturists, they depended on rains, sufficient rains, and he had many cows. Nanda Maharaj was a farm man. He agriculture and cows. The mercantile people, the Vaishya community, they are recommended three things. Krishi, Goraksha, Vanijyam. Krishi means agriculture. And Goraksha means cow protection. And Vanijyam means trade. So Nanda Maharaj belonged to the Vaishya community. So he was a well-to-do man, a very rich man. And he had 900,000 of cows. 900,000 of cows he was protecting. Formerly, according to Vedic civilization, a man was considered to be rich man in proportion of his stock of grains and livestock, cows, that's all. Dhanena dhanavan. A man was considered to be rich man if he has sufficient quantity of grains at his possession, in his possession. Similarly, if one has sufficient number of cows in his possession, he was considered rich man. Not that bank balance. There was no such bank, neither this paper money. They possessing the foodstuff and milk. And actually, this is economic solution. If you have got sufficient milk, then you can make so many nice nutritious, full of vitamin values, preparation and grains. So there is no question of economic starvation if you have got simply grains and cows. So that was the standard of economic solution in days, yore. So they were preparing just to satisfy the demigod Indra, because he was supposed to supply, not supposed, actually he supplies rains sufficiently. Without rains you cannot have successful agriculture. So they were preparing that sacrifice. So this preparation was being observed by Krishna and Balaram. Krishna is the youngest and Balaram is the eldest. Balaram is son of Rohini and Krishna is son of Devaki. Both these ladies, Rohini and Devaki, they were wives of Vasudeva, Krishna's father. So Balaram was born of Rohini and Krishna was born of Devaki, Devaki Nandana Gopal. Devaki Nandana. So they were not very, there was not much difference of their age, say 1 year or 2 years like that. So Balaram was eldest brother, they were playing together. And this is an incident when Balaram was about 8 years old and Krishna was about 7 years old. So Bhagavan Tatraya Baladevana Sangjutaha. Bhagavan, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, along with Baladev, his elder brother, apashyan sa. What is that? Sa nivasan gopa indriyajaga kitodama. All the cowherd's men, including his father, they were preparing for sacrifice of Indraja. Tadavigyopi Bhagavan Sarvatma Parisarvadarshana Prashaya Vanata Aprichyat Vridhyan Nanda Purogaman. He was the Supreme Personality Godhead. He knew everything, what they were doing and what was the purpose. Because he is present in everyone's heart, See, he knows everything. But because he was playing just like a boy, a cowherd boy, so as if he did not know anything, he asked, inquired from his father and the elderly persons who were assisting his father for preparing the sacrifice. Tadadvigopi, this very word is used here, that he knew everything. Bhagavan, because Bhagavan means he must know everything, past, present, future. There is no lack of knowledge. And several times described before you, Bhagavan means he's full of all opulences, and there are six opulences. Riches, strength, fame, beauty, knowledge and renunciation. So Bhagavan cannot be lack of knowledge. He must know everything. That is Bhagavan. So therefore it is said, what is the use of asking his father what they were going to do? He knew everything, but it is specifically mentioned, atad abhigopi, although he knew it, because he was playing the part of a boy. And the father knew that Krishna is my son. They did not recognize him, that he is personality of Godhead. They knew, he is my ordinary son. Tad abhigopi Bhagavan sarvatma. Sarvatma means one who is situated in everyone's heart. Sarvatma. Sarvadarshana. Sarvadarshana means one who can see everything, past, present and future. Still, prasyavana vanata, just like an obedient son, submissive son, aprichyat vridhyanando purogama. He, elderly persons of his father's friend and associates, with very humbleness, he inquired. He inquired. And what is that inquiry? Kattathangme pita koyam sambhramo va upagataha king phalam kasa chodesha kina va saddhati makha etat bhi mahan kama mahihang susu sabi pitaha. My dear father, I very respectfully and humbly am inquiring, what is this arrangement? Why you are busy in some making some sacrificial ceremony, and what is the reason and what is the result? King Phalam, what is the result of doing this? King Phalam, kasa cha uddesha, by whom you are trying to satisfy, kena va saddhate, and what is the purpose of the sacrifice? So I cannot understand. Will you kindly explain to me? Etat brihi mahan kama. I am very much anxious. Kindly explain to me. Etat mahan kama. Mayang susu savivita. Oh, I am your most obedient son. So you kindly explain to me. This question was posed.
Nahi gopang hi sadunang krittang sarvatma manam yaha asta saparadrishti nam mitra dushas tad vidham.
Now, if you think that it is very confidential, it cannot be disclosed, then I think for a person like you who is doing publicly such sacrifice, you should not explain to me.
Nahi gopang hi sadhunam.
Sadhu, those who are saintly person, for them there is no secret. There is no secret. There is no privacy. A sadhu has no privacy. Just now, in our ordinary social affairs, there is difference between private life and his public life. And now somebody is teacher. Now he is very good teacher. He can very good, he can explain very nicely a subject matter. but his private life is not very good, then he is not a teacher, he is not a sadhu. That is Vedic conception. One must be a teacher according to his own behavior in life. There is no secrecy or privacy. Now we think, you don't mind what his private character, you don't mind. We are concerned with his teaching. No. That sort of teaching will not have any effect. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Apani Achari Prabhu Jivere Shikaya. The teacher must demonstrate in his practical life what he is teaching. And that is the meaning of acharya. Acharya means the teacher must demonstrate things by applying the same things in his own life. That is called acharya. Therefore, Krishna said, that you cannot disclose anything, keep anything private, please disclose.
Udasinam, udasina aridvajyam atmavasuhit uchyate.
And even if it is very confidential, I am your son, you can explain to him, I am your well-wisher.
ज्ञात्या गत्या च कर्माणि जनयम् अनुतिष्ठन्ति विदुषः कर्म सिद्धस्य तथा न अविदुषो भवेत्.
Whether this is a superstition, let's see how Krishna is speaking. Whether it is a superstition or it has got some actual effect, you should not do anything religious rituals under superstition. That is the recommendation of Krishna. Krishna does not like that people should perform anything under superstition. Suppose if you are sacrificing, if you are doing some ceremony, you must have thorough knowledge that that must be the result. That must be the result. Just like there are many sacrifices recommended in the Vedic literature. Putrishti Jagya. Putrishti, suppose a man has no son, and if he performs that sacrifice, he will have his son. That is a fact. Similarly, so many things there. So, any rituals, religious rituals, now according to Krishna, how practical he is. He says that no religious ritual should be performed without practical effect. Without practical effect. People have become atheists because in the modern age there are so many rituals in all religions. Not only Hindu religion but Christian religion. But they say simply formalities, there is no effect. There is no effect. The sort of rituals, religious ceremony, is not recommended by Krishna. You must actually the effect. Just like in Puranas, there was a talk between Lord Chaitanya and Kaji, Chand Kaji. Chand Kaji was a Mohammedan magistrate. And Lord Chaitanya, when he started the Sankirtan movement, there was many complaints. Just like we are receiving daily reports that our Sankirtan movement is disturbing some tenets here. Similarly, when Lord Chaitanya started the Sankirtan, some of the Brahmins, because Lord Chaitanya said that this is the only religion. This chanting of Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, this is the only religious principle and everyone will have all his desires fulfilled by his chanting this. So the Brahmins, those who are priestly class, they thought that if people take to this only chanting, then what about our churches and mosques and temples? They will not come. So they lodged a complaint to the magistrate that this is not Hindu religion. He has discovered something in his own fertile brain, so we do not recognize it. So this complaint was lodged before the magistrate, and the magistrate took step. First of all, warned him, don't chant Hare Krishna. Then when he did not care, then sent some constables, and the drums had broken. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu started civil disobedience movement. So he did not care for the magistrate. He started Sankirtan throughout the whole city of Navadvip. Then they approached the magistrate's house. Just the other day, there was a procession in your city. So this civil disobedience movement was started first by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Now there was some compromising talk with the magistrate, and in that talk, the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu first questioned, because he was Mahavidyan, the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that in your religion, there is killing of father and mother. What sort of religion this is? Then Kaji replied, how do you say that we are killing our father? Yes, you are killing your mother. Cow gives you milk, delivers milk, you drink the milk, and you kill the cow. Therefore, you are killing your mother. So the Kaji replied that in your Vedic literature also, I have seen, there is cow sacrifice. The Chaitanya Mahaprabhu replied that that is not cow sacrifice. That is rejuvenation of cow. Old cows were sacrificed in the fire, and again a new life was given by the Vedic mantra. But because there is lack of such expert Brahmins to chant that mantra, therefore cow sacrifice in this age is forbidden. So when the things are not practical, that becomes a forbidden. If you actually get the result by some spiritual religious rituals, performance, then it is very good. Otherwise, it is simply superstition. Lord Chaitanya's opinion is that because all these Vedic injunctions, sacrifices, they are not possible to be performed in this age. They are very difficult. There is no expert leader to perform all these ceremonies and rituals. Therefore, take to this, Hare Krishna, take to this. There is no need of rituals, there is no need of expenses. Simply, God has given you tongue and God has given you ear. Just go on chanting Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, and it will fulfill your spiritual advance. Similarly, Krishna says, Gyatya agyatyacha karmani janayam anutishthanti. Generally, mass of people, they are ignorant. They perform some religious rituals, knowingly or unknowingly, as a matter of superstition or custom. Vidusha karma siddhasya. But one who is intelligent, he should know that by this sacrifice I must get the result. Vidusho karma siddhasya tatha na vidusho bhave. And those are fools, they are simply by superstition, they do it. So Krishna did not recommend that you should do something under superstition. No, you must do it for practical result. This dogmatism, fanaticism, why I shall chant Hare Krishna? I am Christian, I am Jews. This is fanaticism. If you find actually ecstasy by chanting Hare Krishna, why should you not? Why should you not? No, I am Jew, I am Christian, I am Mohammedan. Well, it is transcendental vibration from the spiritual platform. Your Mohammedanism, Christianism, Hinduism, Buddhism, this is skin disease. This is because you have got some particular body at particular circumstances, and therefore you claim like that. But actually, we are all spirit soul. And this sound vibration is from the spirit soul. It will appeal to everyone. See the effect. Then, don't be fanatist, don't be, sectarian. The Krishna wants that. By custom, one should not follow the rituals. One should see the effect.
तत्र तावत् क्रिया जागो भवतां किं विचारितः अथवा लौकिकं लौकिकस्थानमि पृच्छता साधु.
So, whether you are confident of the result of the sacrifice, he's asking his father. Just see, Krishna was a boy and he's asking his father, whether you are confident of the result of the sacrifice, you are going to satisfy the demigod sacrifice, or athoba lokika, or it is simply a custom, village custom, that you are doing it. Lokika stan me prichata sadhu bhannata. Now I am very much inquisitive to learn from you. Please explain. Now his father is explaining.
Parjanna Bhagavan Indra मेघास्तस्यात्ममूर्तय ते अभिवर्षन्ति भूतानां प्रीरणं जीवनं परापय.
He says, my dear boy, what is very essential, because without rains we cannot have any produce. Therefore, this rain is controlled by Bhagavan Indra, the heavenly king Indra. He controls the Megha means cloud. He is the master of the cloud. He can send cloud and he can stop cloud. He is a representative of God, so he has got the power.
Te abhi varshanti bhutanang priranang.
So when he allows this raining, people become satisfied, they get their produce.
Tam tata bhayamasse cha vamuchang patimisharam drabbais tad retosha siddhai jajanti kratubhi nara.
Therefore it is our duty, because he supplies us water. So it is our duty to show him respect by this sacrifice. This is the Vedic injunction. Just like we pay departmental tax, we pay to the corn addition bills for the supply of electricity and gas. Similarly, we pay the bills of the telephone, but we have no program to pay the bills of the sun, who is supplying us so much light. What is that?
The needle doesn't seem to be working.
Sir, it is our duty to sacrifice. According to Vedic rituals, these are recommended, that we should satisfy. So, Nanda Maharaj explained.
Tatcha ishasana upajivanti thivarga phalahetave pungsang purusakaranang parjanna phalabhavana.
Now, this water is so important that it will produce grains and we shall lead and for perfection of our life, we must first live. So, this is very important thing. So, we have to satisfy Indra.
Jayavam visuje dharmam parampajyagata naraha kamat lobhat bhayad desha sabai naknati sovanam.
He says, my dear boy, that we should not give up this parampara. Parampara means coming from disciplic succession or from generation. My father did it, my father's fathers did it. So every religious ceremony and according to Vedic rituals, there come parampara, family or society-wise or community-wise, in every country there is. So he says that this parampara, this successive generation we have been doing this, and we should not give it up. He understood Krishna's purpose that he is asking. He's a very intelligent boy. So he's asking me all these questions just to forbid me. That he's just like father, like son. The father was also intelligent. So Jayvang Bishiji Dharmam. Dharmam means one must and execute. That is dharma. That is just like to become hungry. It is my religion. This is called religion. We should know what is the meaning of religion. Religion means which we cannot separate from itself. The religion which we can change, that is not religion. Suppose I am Hindu, I become Christian. So neither this Hinduism is religion or Christianism is religion. It is a dictionary, English dictionary word. But dharma, according to Sanskrit, dharma does not mean that which you can change. I have several times explained this fact. Dharma cannot be changed. Therefore, we must find out what is our dharma, what is our religion, which we are professing, that Christianity is my religion, Hinduism my religion. That is not religion, that is faith. Religion is different. Religion you cannot change. You cannot change. That is the meaning of religion. Here it is said that Jayvang Bhishije Dharmam. Dharmam means you cannot change. So Parampajagatanara Kamat. Kamat Lobhat. Now religion sometimes when it is taken as faith, they are changed. How they are changed? Kamat, for some gain. Just like in India, formerly, Christian religion was preached giving some facilities. And generally, we see that Christian and priests who go to foreign countries, I have seen, they offer some hospital facilities, some economic facilities, the poor man, they supply clothing and education. So those who are poor, they become captivated and they have practically no religion. Anyway, they are facing the economic problems. So kamat, kamat means for some gain. For some gain, kamat, lobhat. Lobhat means by some greediness. And bhayat, bhayat means out of fear. And deshat, deshat means out of enviousness. For all these things, one should not give up his faith or religion. So that was the explanation of Nanda Maharaj, father of Krishna. Now Krishna replying, see Bhagavan uvacha. The reason of that sacrifice, as explained by Nanda Maharaj, is that Indra, the heavenly king, he supplies us water. Therefore, we must perform the sacrifice to satisfy him. Now, Krishna is giving reason, just like an atheist. Just like an atheist. Karma Mimamsa, there are six philosophers. Out of that, one is Karma Mimamsa. Karma Mimamsa means one who takes work and the result of work. Nothing, no God, nothing. You work like this, you get the result. The just like modern theory. So Krishna is putting up that karma mimamsa. What is that? He says, karmana jayate jantu karmanaiva viliyate. Everyone is born here out of, as the effect of his past deeds. And karmanaiva viliyate, and he is going to have his next birth according to the work as he is doing here. This is called karma mimamsa. The karma mimamsa philosophers, they do not believe that our liberation from this material world and entrance into the spiritual kingdom to be associated with God, that will make us happy. Their belief is that you simply do good work, then you gradually get your promotion. That is also a fact. That is not a misconception. If you do good work, then you get good birth. Janma Isharja Sutta see four things: good birth, meaning good family or good nationality, and Janma. Birth means, Janma means birth, good birth. Janma Isharja, and to become rich. Sutta, to become very learned, and Sri, and to become very beautiful. These are results of past good work. So here Krishna says that people are concerned with his work. A man is concerned with his work. Karmana jayate jantu karmanaiva viliyate. He gets his facilities of life according to the past good work, bad work, and he is preparing his life next by that work. Sukhaṁ dukhaṁ bhayaṁ cīmaṁ karmaneiva abhipappate. So therefore, either happiness or distress or fearfulness or poverty or economic question, everything depends on this karma, on this work. Asti chedishara kaschet phalarupi annakarmanam kattaraṁ bhajate sopi nahi kartu prabhurhi sa. Now supposing there is somebody, because these atheists, they do not believe in God. Now they are giving arguments. Now suppose there is somebody as God or some supervisor or something like that. But still, he is obliged to give me the effect. Therefore, I am not going to ask mercy from that superior personality, a God or something else. I have to work. And this is also a fact. Suppose you are going to appear in some examination. Now, the university is giving you some designation. Now, that designation practically depends on your passing the examination. What is the use of flattering that examiner? That is the argument. There is no... His argument is that you are, after the sacrifice of satisfying the Indra, so indirectly he says that the Indra is appointed by the Lord and he has to supply water. He is the officer. So what is the use of flattering him? Just like there are many officers in the New York City. One is in charge of the water work department. So there is no question of flattering that water works department officer. You pay your tax, you work nicely, and your water will be supplied to you. But if you don't pay your tax, however you flatter that officer, your connection will be cut off. So it depends on your work. It depends on your work. Asti chet ishara kaschet. Supposing there is some God. There is some God. Just see, a God is preaching atheism. He is God himself, and he says, supposing if there is some God. Supposing if there is some God, kaschit phalarupi anna karmana, and he gives the result of your work. The Karma Mimamsa philosophers, they accept God in this way. Suppose there is God and He is to give us the result, so He is obliged. If we do nice work, He is obliged. So what is the use of flattering God? Let us do our duty nicely, then He will be obliged. So Krishna is forwarding that argument. Asti ced isharat kasti phalarupa anna phalarupi anna karmanam kartarang bhajate sopi. He also worships the worker. The worker has not to worship God. Because God gives you good result out of your good work. Therefore, because you are doing good work, therefore God is worshipping. Just see the argument. He says, Kartaram bhajate sopi nahi akartu prabhuvi. And one who does not do good work, God does not like him. So there is no necessity of this worshipping this heavenly God or any God. So let us have our duty done nicely. That will fetch us the desired result. Kimindrena hyabhritya bhutanam sasya karmanuvartinam anishina annathakurtu svabhava bhitanginam. So therefore there is no necessity of satisfying this Indra. You are simply wasting your time.
Svabhavataya hi jana svabhava anuvartate svabhavasamidam sarvam sadeva asura manasam.
Everyone is acting according to the modes of nature he has acquired. So whatever nature we have acquired, his purpose is that by nature we are mercantile people. Because his father was maintaining cows, so he is considered a mercantile man. Vaishyakarma svabhava. Krishi goraksha vanijyam vaishyakarma svabhava. So he is giving stress that let us perform our duty as mercantile man honestly, and that will bring us result. Why should we go to worship these demigods? Now here is the point that Krishna does not approve the worship of demigods. That is also stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Kamastastra hitajnana jajanti anna devata. Those who are out of intelligence, they simply worship the demigods. In the Bhagavad Gita or in the Bhagavad, anywhere, and worship of demigod is not very much recommended. So here also the same thing, that svabhavatantra hi jana, everyone is carried by the modes of nature. Svabhavam anuvartate, and he cannot surpass the spell of the modes of nature. Svabhavat anuvartate, svabhavastam idam sarvam. Everyone is under the control of the nature he has acquired. And sadeva asura manusa, sadeva, always, either he is man or superman or animal, everyone is being controlled by the modes of nature.
Dehanuchyavachanajantu prapo sijyati karmana satru mitra mudashina karmaiva gururishara.
He is giving so much stress on karma. There is no question of bhakti here.
So dehanuvachana,
there is a difference of high grade body and low grade body. There are different kinds of body. Somebody has got very high grade body, very intelligent, very rich, very beautiful, very wealthy, and somebody has low grade body. So dehanuchyavachana jantu prapati siddhati karmana. Now these high grade and low grade bodies are obtained according to the work he has done.
Satru mitra mudasina karmaiva guru rishara.
and one is the leader, or one is a teacher, or one is enemy, or one is friend. Everything is judged by this karma, by work. Just see how much he is giving stress and work. Karmaiva. Karmaiva Guru Rishana. Tasma sampujayet karma sabhavastasa karma krit. Anyasa jena vartate tadevasa ihai daivatam. Therefore, you don't bother yourself about worshipping this god or that god, demigod. You just be faithful to your work and then that will give you good result. Anyasa jena vartate na tave daivatam. आजीविका तरंग भावं जस्तु अन्नोपजीवति न तस्मात् बिन्दते क्षीमं जारं नार्य सति यथा. ही इज कंडेमनिंग दैट वन्स प्रोफेशन. ही हैज लॉर्ड कृष्णा हैज इन द भगवद गीता आल्सो सेड लाइक दैट सकर्मणातम भर्ज वन शुड नॉट गिव अप हिज ओन प्रोफेशन. नेवर माइंड इवन इट इज फॉल्टी. You have heard it from me. Just like he has given the example that fire is so pure, still there is fault, there is more. So, in spite of all fault, one should not give up his own work, but he should do it faithfully and nicely, and the result will come. Adivekkataranga bhavang jastu, and he says here, that anyone who gives us his own natural profession, natural aptitude, profession, so, natasmat bindati chimang, jarang najasati jatha, jarang najasati jatha. Now, this is a very important question. Najasati, asati. Asati means not chaste omen. That's like in India, policy is very strict that the woman is not to give up her husband and acquaint herself with any other man. This example is given that if an unchaste woman gives us her own husband and makes friends with others, similarly, one who gives us his own profession and takes other profession, he is also similarly unchaste. Najasati yatha varteta brahmana vipra rajanna rakhaya bhuva. Therefore, one should not deviate from his professional duties, just like the Brahmins, varteta brahmana vipra. Those who are Brahmins, they should stick to their principle of life, simply spiritual culture. Rajanna rakhaya bhuva, and those who are kshatriyas, they should stick to their protecting the citizen, the kingly order, royal order. Their duty is to give protection to the. They should not simply collect tax. The kshatriyas, this king, is allowed to collect tax because he is supposed to give all protection to the people. So therefore it is said, Rajanna Rakhaya Bhuva. Rajanna means the royal order, stick to his principle, how to give protection to the people. Similarly, Vaishastu Bhartvaya Jivat, Chudrastu Dijasevaya. Similarly, these mercantile, they should live on their trade, and those who are Shudra, those who are laborer class, they should serve all these three classes. That is the rules. Now, Krishi Vanijya Goraksha Kusidang Surjamuchyate Varta Chutibhidha Tatra Vayango Vrittayo Anisham. Now, according to scripture, we are Vaishya, and we should live not in a Brahminical way or Kshatriya's way or Shudra's way, but we should live just like Vaishyas, and we are actually agriculturists. and we are actually protecting cows, therefore we are Vaishyas. Our duty is to stick to our, faithfully stick to our business, stick to our work. What is the use of worshipping this god or that god?
Sattam rajastama iti sthitutpati hetava rajasatpaddate visham annam vividham jagat.
Now he is forwarding the atheistic theory of Kapila, Sankhya philosophy. Sankhya philosophy. Sankhya philosophy theory is that there is no controller, there is no God, but it is the world is moving under nature's interaction. Just the modern scientists also say like that. The world, every action of this material world is being acted just like Sankhya philosophy is based on this philosophy that a man and woman is attracted and they have sex life and the son is produced. And there is no other reason for population. Simply a man wants a woman and a woman wants a man, that natural tendency is there, and when they combine together, there is a birth of a child. So this is a natural sequence. The Sankhya philosophy is based on this principle. They do not believe that above these there is God, Nirisha. Above this there is God, there is God's control. Actually there is God. Sexual intercourse is not the cause of a child. According to Bhagavad, a living entity, before his death, and he is by superior judgment, it is thought that where this living entity, where this particular man or dog or anything is dying, where it will be placed. So when that place is sanctioned, the place is selected that this particular man should go in such and such body, then he is at once transferred to the seminar. That small particle, spiritual particle, is transferred to the seminar of the father, and the father injects the seminar into the mother's womb, and it gets a particular type of body according to his karma. That is Bhagavad's version. But the Sankhya philosophy, they say, because they have no idea that there is spiritual spark, they think simply the father and mother and man and woman, sex life produces life. So here, practically, the same thing is advocated by Krishna, that sattang rajastamayati sthitutpati hetava. Now the creation of this material world is the three modes of material nature. There is no other cause. There is no other cause. Rajasa chodita megha varasanti ambani sarvata. So when there is too much heat by, aggravation of the modes of passion, there is evaporation of water, and that becomes cloud. That is the cause of, the cloud is the cause of rain. Why do you go to this Indra and Chandra and all this? Just see Krishna how he is speaking atheistically. So, prajastaireva siddhanti mahendra kinkarishyati. Therefore, that rain constitutes agriculture. So why do you bother about this mahendra? Just like modern scientists say that we shall artificially make raining so that where there is scarcity of rain, we shall fertilize the land, we shall get production. So similarly, the Sankhya philosophy, according to Sankhya philosophy, that rain is caused by the heat, and by the heat and there is cloud in the sky, and the cloud is the cause of the rain. There is no question of Mahendra, the controller of the cloud or anything else.
प्रजास्त्रैरेव सिद्धन्ति मैद्रं किं करिष्यति न न पुरजनपदा न ग्रामा न गृहाङ्गवय बनुकशास्तत्नित्यं वनशैलनिवासन सो दैट फॉर वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू द सिटी वी आर इनहेबिटेंट्स ऑफ दिस विलेज सो इट इज बेटर टू वर्शिप दिस लैंड गोवर्धन बिकॉज कृष्णा वॉज हर्डिंग his cows on the Govardhan hill, so indirectly he hinted that we should worship this Govardhan hill, and that is our duty. So it is a long story, 3-4 chapters. Of course, it will take some time. I don't think you can give us so much time. The result is that when Krishna talked like this, then his father agreed not to perform the sacrifice, because all the inhabitants of Braja, Vrindavan, they are so much fond of Krishna, whatever Krishna will say, they will accept. So although Krishna was a boy, so he implored his father and other elderly gentlemen present there that there is no need of performing the sacrifice. So they stopped sacrifice. As a result of the stopping, Indra became very much angry, and there was torrents of rain, incessant rain, and very violently. So the whole village and whole tract of land comprising the Brajabhumi, they become overflooded, and the cows and the animals and the people become too much afflicted. So they had no other source. They approached Krishna, protect us. Krishna, protect us. So at that time Krishna said, yes, I will give you protection. So he was, although a boy of 6 or 7 years old, he lifted that hill. If any time you go to India, you will see the hill. It is not less than at least 5-6 miles area, very big hill. That hill was lifted by him, and he kept that hill in his hand for 7 days. And then everything was cleared. Then Indra prayed him. So there are many things after this. That today Krishna lifted this hill, therefore his name is Giridhari. Giridhari means who held the hill. Giri means the hill, and Dhari means one who holds up. So today is that is the annual ceremony of today, this Govardhan Puja. So we follow that principle because we are devotees of Krishna. We are trying to follow his instruction. So at noon time we shall perform this puja, and you are invited to take prasadam. I think prasadam will be ready by 11 o'clock, and you will kindly participate in taking prasadam.